Sergeant, present colors.
Present, go.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tim Kettler singing the national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed and the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and the bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming and the rockets regular the bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say
Church, Catholic Church, for coming and giving us the invitation.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
It's my humble honor to be a part of this wonderful event. Thank you, Bridget, for inviting me. Almighty God, whose great commandment is that we shall love neighbor as ourselves, and who has taught us that we should do to others as we would have done to us, we ask your blessing upon the work for families of active military. As our purpose is to help our fellow citizens, and especially those who have served this nation with honor in time of conflict, and to promote all that serves well our communities and our state and our nation. So we pray that you will enlighten our minds with a clearer vision of your will for us. Inspire our determination to follow that vision of your will in all of our deliberations, and strengthen our hands in all of our undertakings. May the program developed here inspire and enrich the lives of our fellow citizens. May the dedication offered here be a source of strength on our communities, that their work may bear fruit for our ideals and aspirations under you, O Father. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And if it's your custom, I'd like to offer a blessing for the food, so if you'd like to bow your head. Blessed are you, O Lord, King of the universe. You bring forth food from the earth and sustain all your creation with goodness, mercy, and grace. We cherish the memories of the past, and with fondness and gratitude, we gather with our friends and associates whom you have blessed us with. We are grateful for all who share our heritage and our patriotism. Bless them and nourish all with thy spirit of love and obedience. Bless the food that we will partake to our physical bodies so that our spirits will be lifted in praise to you and for all and all of your blessings. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Blind, but now
want to thank all of you so much for being here and supporting this event. There are so many of you that have been helping us throughout the years on something that was a wild dream that we came up with in a car one day and truly believed we could make happen. And now that we have families coming to the place, we really don't. That's my great niece. She's loud like me. And now that we have actually had military families coming up to stay at the lodge, it's hard to believe that we're actually doing it. But there are so many people from behind the scenes that we can't thank you enough for all of your help. Our goal right now is to, in the next couple years, raise $1 million. I'd like to do it in a year. I'd like to do it tonight if anybody has an extra. Yeah, never know. We want to buy a house out. You see, we have to buy a house outright. We're a nonprofit organization. And I figure by the time we buy the property and you know, fix it up a little bit here and there, it'll cost us about $1 million. So that's our goal. And we're hoping to make some good corporate contacts as we go along. And right now we have a couple of special guests. I just want to make a note of that are here tonight. We have, other than, hello, 16 Marines and 8 soldiers. Hello. That we have more Marines than soldiers, okay? I'm not one to cause a little friction, but we have more Marines than soldiers. Next year, Army, go strong. We have our commanding officer of the MAG 16. We're honored to have he and his wife here tonight, Colonel Chad Blair and his beautiful, lovely wife, Lilia. We have Christine Winicky. She's a family readiness officer from CLB 5. And we'll explain what she does later. We have Command Sergeant Major, new to his job, Daniel O'Brien. Where are you? Hey. O'Brien. We have our former mayor and city council member sitting here with us tonight, Jean Hernandez, and his lovely wife. We also have our guest here tonight is Julian Babbitt.
Tara,
I didn't see her. Hi, Tara. I love Tara. Tara's running. Tara is a new candidate. She's running for city council of Garibaldi. Great lady. We don't know why she's doing it. We're trying to talk her out of it. You know, they're all crazy. Anyway, we'll start. We will let the Marines and the Army, if you would please go in line first and get your dinner, and we'll just start. Oh yeah, that's gonna be crazy. Let's just start at this table here and just start going out, get your dinner, and come back in. Thank you very much. Service and attending today, and we'll start with him.
evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is James Johnson. I go by Chip. I'm the Sergeant Major of Marine Air Group 15. I've been in the Marine Corps 28 years, 7 months, and 5 days.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Sasser Ramirez. I work in Mount 16, the squadron guns there. I have not counted yet. I've got another 7 more years to go, but I definitely want to thank everybody for allowing us to be able to partake today, and I'm definitely grateful and thankful. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Sergeant Dixon. I'm with Marine Wing Headquarters Squadron 3. I've been in for 4 years.
Sergeant Major Daniel O'Brien. I am the installation Sergeant Major of Fort Irwin, California, and I am proud. proud to be a part of this org, this event tonight. Thank you, Bridget. This is wonderful. And I think you can say there's more Marines here, but we are all brothers and sisters in arms.
All right.
Today, I was like, says, God bless America.
But Ed and I started this this organization, which we didn't know we were starting an organization, as many of you know. It started out to help some families at Christmas. And it kind of just mushroomed into what it is today. There were so many people that wanted to say thank you to our servicemen and women for what they do. They came out of the woodwork to help us. And we adopted 5 families that first year for Christmas. And we got them late, it's a long story, but I had to call the commandant to say, okay, nobody at Camp Hamilton knows where to put me. Could you please give me some, show me where to go, tell somebody to call me. So he did, and they did. And I got 5 families, they all had 4, 5, and 6 children, military-led babies. And I emailed and called everybody I knew. And I said, if you don't have time to shop, just send me money. Okay, what the heck? So they sent the money. Phyllis Amato and her daughter Lisa. I said, I have this money, and we have to go shopping. So the 3 of us went shopping, if you remember correctly. And when we were done, we had gifts for each of these family members, 4 gifts. And we had $2,000 left over. Well, of course, what do I do with the money? It's not mine. So I looked at it, and my dad always taught me a lesson. A man put a few bucks in his pocket. So we took the money and we divided it up between the families. If they had 3 kids, they got $300. If they had 4 kids, they got to help with expenses, help with food, help with gas, whatever it might be. But from that, we went on and continued to add programs and support to our military. We are lucky we live in today's age. There are people in the room who are in the Vietnam War and were not treated as such. How many here were in the Vietnam War? Lieutenant Commander, yeah. Tom. Thank you. And whether you've given us a lot of money, or you wrote us a check for $25, or you helped us wrap presents, or you worked in the kitchen, we have Anna Tom Moore. What would I do without him on our big Thanksgiving dinner? He's not here tonight. But we cook the food the day before, and he gets it out on that table hot. It takes so many of us to do what we want to do, honestly. Everybody has a role in it. Somebody will say, well, I can't do much. Yes, but you brought so-and-so with you, or you introduced me to so-and-so. Your contacts are what make our work possible. You make our work possible. We have strikes. Frank Stefano, speaking of hands. For those of you who don't know Frank, he owns Stefano Hams. He and his wife are absolutely, truly wonderful people. They donate their hams every year. He brings them over to my house. Whatever we need, he's there to help us. Gary Adams, where are you? Gary Adams. If nobody knows Gary Adams, but you know what Gary Adams says? On Thanksgiving Eve day,
Gary the booze.
Gary makes our booze run. He goes to Costco. He goes to the places that we need picking up to get things done. How many people in here help cook on Thanksgiving Day before the day before the meal? Several women in this room, I know. So, thank you enough for all you do. All right. That are going to do a few, we're going to speed this along now that my windbagging is done. And the first I'm going to call up Jean Hernandez, please. You would like to say a few words?